the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's shall we have our sickness. I want to thank our mommy and our daddy for the privilege given to me and to speak to you wonderful people of God. I bless you, the Lord will bless you more and more in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And prosper his work in your hands in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And to my fellow women, I congratulate you. Say to the world with you all in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Your womb will be blessed in the mighty name of
Amen.
Jesus. Please come with me to Matthew chapter 15. Matthew 15, I read from verse 21 to 28. Matthew 15, 21 to 28. Then Jesus went thence and departed into the coast of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a woman of Cana came out of the same coast and cried unto him, saying, Have mercy on me, O Lord, thou son of David. My daughter is grievously vexed with a devil. But he answered her not a word. And his disciples came and besought him, saying, Send her away, for she cries after us. But he answered and said, I'm not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Then came she and worshipped him, saying, Lord, help me. But he answered and said, It is not meet to take the children's bread and to cast it to dogs. And she said, Truth, Lord, yet the dogs eat of the crumbs which fall from their master's table. Then Jesus answered and said unto her, O woman, great is thy faith, be it unto thee, even as thou wilt. And her daughter was made whole from that very hour. Shall we pray? Let your glory fill this house, O Lord. Let the praises fill my heart. Let this vessel offer unto you a sacrifice of praise. Be given to me,
Amen.
That I may open my word, my mouth boldly to make known the mystery of the gospel.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I say, praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Women in the house shout hallelujah once again. This is the day that the Lord has made. We are going to rejoice and be glad in it. It is a day that we have to tell ourselves the truth as women. It is a day of appraisal, of reflection and revelation. And all this we shall get as we go along with this service in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I've been asked to speak on the topic Women of Faith. But I would like to go to the roots of women, the creation of women. There are keywords, the women and the faith. So we look at the two before joining the two together. Women, we are created by God. We are special breed, created by God to assist man, specifically to assist man in actualizing the purpose of God for their life. Women are special breed created by God to assist men to actualize the purpose of God for their lives. You will ask me why, where did I get this information? Or what gives me, why, how did I get the definition? But you talk with me, so Genesis chapter 2. And the Lord God, I'll read from verse 13. And the Lord God took the man and put him into the garden of Eden to dress and to keep it. That is verse 13 of that Genesis 2. Then in verse 18, the Lord said, and the Lord God said, it is not good for that good that the man should be alone. I will make him and help meet. Verse 20, and Adam gave names to all the cattle and the fowl of the air, and to every beast of the field. But for Adam, there was not found and help meet. So we are actually help meet to our men. We are not their head, they are our head. We are just to support them. I've had many women complaining, I'm the one doing this, I'm the one doing that. You are created for such time like that, like this, to support your man where his hand is weak, to lift him up. And you will see that at that moment, as you obey, believing the word of God, having faith in the word of God, you will see that the Lord will bless you more and more. But as long as you refrain from doing that, you see that anguish, sorrow, crisis will fill the home. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
We have the vital component that makes a man complete. A woman can make a man. A woman can marry a man. We have heard that behind every successful man, there is a woman. Why did I say so? God also, in Genesis 2, that's in Genesis 2, 21 to 24, after he has seen the need for a helpmate for the man, he caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he took one of his ribs, and he closed the flesh, and he made woman with that tree. And he brought her to Adam. And Adam said, yes, actually, this is the bone of my bone and the flesh of my flesh, and she shall be called woman. That rib that was taken, don't forget, God did not put any seal. It's still vacant. But as long, that's why they talk about compatibility. When the bone fits in, then everything goes well in the home. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And in that spirit, he said, therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother and cleave unto his wife, and the two of them shall become one. Because that bone, that rib that was taken, is now replaced. The man is now a complete man. And that's why you see that in various organizations, when you have that, getting to the management, top management stage. If you're not married, they will not give you that post. They will ask the man to go and marry. Because they know that the challenges will be too enormous for him without a woman in his life. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now I'll talk about faith. It is written in Hebrews 11, chapter 1, verse 1. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. It is absolute confidence in God's will, purpose, and absolute belief that God, through His Son, Jesus Christ, will answer our prayers. When we believe, then everything will come to pass. Because the woman in the passage we read believed that it's only God, he believed in the power of the Most High God, she believed in Jesus. That was why she refused to go. She was persistent that today my daughter must be brought back to life. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
How do you acquire this faith? How do you acquire it? You acquire it by listening to the Word of God, by studying the Word of God, by believing the Word of God, by acting that Word of God, by expressing that Word of God, by speaking that Word of God. This is written in Romans 10:17. It said, faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. It's not enough to hear it, but you must live it. Faith is important to every Christian. And it is also written, but without faith it is impossible for us to please God. But for he that cometh to you must believe that he is, and he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. It's also written, the just shall live by faith. So you now ask me, what is the correlation between the woman and faith? I would say, a woman of God, these are the traits that you see in a woman of God. A woman of God or a woman of faith, we love God. We fear God. We acknowledge Him in everything. She will put Him first in everything. In our home, in the lives of our children, in our place of work, God will be first. A woman of faith must be a worshiper of God. In the passage read, the woman, instead of being discouraged, we were told she worshipped. She worshipped God. And thereby, she got answers to her request. A woman of faith must be prayerful. Must be prayerful. A woman of faith must stand in the gap. You see, women will take charge in the home. When there is a problem, we are the one to go on our knees. In Proverbs 31, it is written there that a candle does not go out at night. That means at night she's on her knees, bringing her husband and children before God. The God Almighty uphold them. Many of us, we don't pray for our husbands. We believe they are there. But if you don't pray for your husband, then there is no way you can have peace. You need to, because when he's troubled outside, he's coming back to you. And our home should be a place of refuge. In Proverbs 14, verse 1, the word of God says, a wise woman, every wise woman builds her home. But the foolish ones pluck at it with their hands. It's as what you want to be, so it shall be. God has given us that power. God has given us everything. That's why I said we are a special breed. God has given us everything to excel, to be a true helpmate to our husbands. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Women of God, try and build your home. Do everything you can to build your home. A man that has a good woman at home is known outside. Even in Proverbs 31, which we shall see later, they said the husband is known at the gates. When a man is happy, know that she has a woman, the shock absorber at home. Are we true shock absorbers? Let us ask ourselves. There are many women of faith in the Bible. We have many of them. We have Esther. We have Deborah. We have Rahab. We have Sarah. But these people, they are judged women of faith because of what they did. The word of God says, faith without work is dead. So that is why I will dwell mainly on our work. Not because all the things I highlighted earlier, we all know. We know that as Christians, these are the traits we must demonstrate to show the world that truly we believe in this God. But my sisters, I want you to make Proverbs chapter 31, 10 to 31, your checklist to examine yourself every time to know whether you are still in the faith or whether you are going outside the faith. It is one thing to know the truth and another thing to act, express and reflect the truth. The word of God says, faith without works is dead. Mm-hmm. Many of the women of faith in the Bible were judged faithful women. Hence, I want to reflect on the topic based on the role of women in faith. And this responsibility, in Proverbs 31, starts with our parenting, raising up our children. I want to encourage everyone to read Open Heavens of yesterday and today. They dwell mostly on raising up of children and our behavior at home. In Proverbs 22 verse 6, the word of God says, train a child where he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. Train a child the way he should go. The training starts even from the womb, I would say from the womb. Because when we are pregnant, anything around us, whatever happens to us, the baby in our tummy will leap, there will be movement. If you are singing, the baby in your womb will be responding to whatever you are doing. And from the womb, make most people say, the boy is too small, let us see him, she doesn't understand anything. I tell you, they know, because you don't teach a child how to eat. When you give him or her anything, he knows where the mouth is. So don't let us assume that they don't know anything. They know food, and from there, when you start from that alley, from that foundation, because once the foundation is faulty, then you can never get it right, except the Lord helps us. From the day one, if a child is showing any trait that does not conform with the word of God, please let us attack it there and then. Let us do something about it. Don't look at it that he or she is small. And I want to tell you, if you train them from that age, you are graduating. So one must be strong and firm. They will resist you, but don't be bothered. Proverbs 19:18 says, chasten thy son while there is hope, and let not thy soul spare from his crying. Proverbs 19:18. Chasten thy son while there is hope. That means there's a time that we know hope. When they are fully formed, there's no way you can vent them. But when they are small, you can still adjust and do that and make them to conform to your will. Don't let us spare them because of their crying. Proverbs 23:13-14. Withhold not correction from the child. If thou beatest him with rod, he shall not die. Thou shalt beat him with the rod and shalt deliver his soul from hell. Deuteronomy 11:18-20 says, speak the word of God unto them. Write it in the lintel of your house. Speak it every time while you are sitting down at home, while you are walking on the way, wherever you may be. Try and train this child. Mortify him into the ways of the Lord, God Almighty. God is counting on us. God is relying on us. That is the responsibility God has given unto us, apart from other things. For we will account for their soul. We will account for every child that God has made us to see, not only our biological children. Anyone we will, I mean, it's a privilege to see something. Phineas, when the children of Israel, 1 Chronicles chapter 25, when they sinned to God, and Moses was still telling them that God is angry with them, God sent a plague to them. They were still weeping. Then one of them just crossed in the midnight woman and ran in. Phineas, the grandson of Aaron, saw him. He ran after him. And he threw a javelin. And he killed the two of them. And God, because of that single act, God said, stop the plague. And God said, the peace will never be taken away from the house of sin, even unto his generation. So whatever you want your child to be, whatever your child is demonstrating, is in your hand. A child that will make it in life depends on the woman. Some women, they raise their children, I mean, once they wake them up with curses. And there is power in this tongue. Whatever you decree, the word of God will be established. And the word of God, whatever you have spoken in my ear, so I will do. So let us be careful the way what we say to our children. When we are provoked, let us go before God and say, God, have mercy. Let us ask God for ways, I mean, to mold them. If you are finding any challenge, definitely they will resist you. But don't be discouraged. Don't be discouraged. I want to leave that. I want to go to our roots, the role we play in the lives of our husbands. It is written in Proverbs 31. I'll just take some few verses to explain to you what you need to do, because you are, I mean, the responsibility you are given is both at home and equally in the church. But I'm dwelling on the one at home for now. I've spoken on the role of the children. Now I want to talk about our role to our husband. Let every woman open to Proverbs 31. Proverbs 31. I'll just take some few verses there for you to listen. That is a virtuous woman. A virtuous woman is a woman of faith. Is a woman of God. Only the heart of her husband doth safely trust in her, so that he shall have no need of spoil. Does your husband trust you? Can your husband trust you? I'm asking, can your husband trust you? Let us ask ourselves this question. Verse 12 says, she will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. She will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. I would like Jezebel, that leads our husband away from the way of God to the vanity of life, to the pleasure of the world, partying day and night, not doing the will of God in home, not bringing the children of our children, nurturing them in the way of the Lord. The men that have entrusted this care, this responsibility in our care, how faithful are we to deliver? Will our men be afraid the kind of women they have at home? Our home is supposed to be a place of refuge. That when he's beaten outside, he knows he has somebody at home that he can rely on, that he comfort and console, and make way and find solution to the challenges he's facing outside. Or are we like Delilah, who opened the doors for the enemy to destroy her husband, Samson? Or are we like Abigail, the wife of Nabal, who delivered her husband from the hands of David? David requested for something from Nabal. Nabal was very rich, was a rich man. Or very stingy. He couldn't part with any of his things. But they came, David said to them, I said, please go to Nabal, tell Nabal that please, you should please give my men some things to eat. And Nabal said, who is David? He refused, he didn't give him. And David had purposed it, so that he was going to kill him. But Abigail had, he quickly packed it and ran to David. Women, let us be like Abigail. Let us not be like Delilah. Let us not be like Jezebel. Jezebel is the wife of King Ahab. Ahab was a God-fearing man before the men, but immediately they joined together, she derailed him from the way of the Lord. The Lord bless her home in Jesus' name.
Amen.
She seeketh wool and flax and worketh willingly with her hands. Verse 15 says, she riseth also while it is yet night, and giveth meat to her household, and a portion to her maidens. Are we lazy? Are we hardworking? Are we industrious? Are we enterprising? Do we support our husband? Do we expect our husband to bring everything? No. A woman of faith, a woman of God, will surely, even before the husband comes, she will be the one to do it. And the man will be happy. You always ask your husband, increase my household keep, increase this. People are, some couples are enjoying to have joint accounts. I don't have joint account with my husband. But one thing is certain, everything that I know is needful in the house. I don't collect house. But whatever is needful in the house, I will buy. I will not wait for my husband. And because of that, I'm seeing the blessing.
Amen.
I'm seeing the blessing. Please don't let us wait for the man. The man, they have many things they are thinking about. We have to express their desire. So that when they see us outside too, they will know we are blessed. We have a man behind us. The Lord will bless us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Verse 6 says, she considereth a field and buyeth it. She knows that this is good for my household, this is good for my husband. And she went ahead with her money. She goes ahead and buy the thing. With the fruit of her hands, she planted a vineyard. What are you doing? What are you doing to support your husband? Are you a full-time housewife? No. Find something to do to support this man. Because there will come a time that the man will not be able to cope. And that is why God created you. To be there for him. Some people, when they are handling more than their husband, they believe they are the lords of the house. God has not made you the lord. What you think that your God can take it within a temple of an hour? But as long as you are faithful to your husband, that you give all the resources God has given you unto him, even though he doesn't appreciate it, it does not really matter. You are dwelling in the purpose of the Lord. That is the primary purpose of a woman, to support that man, because God has seen that there will come a time that he will need such help. And that is why you are the helpmeet. The Lord will grant you the grace to fulfill this role in Jesus' name.
Amen.
She gathered, let me verse 18. She perceived that her merchandise is good, and cattle went not out by night. Let us always be on our knees to lift up our husbands and our children, to pray for them. Whatever challenges we are seeing, we do that on our knees. The Lord will bless us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And it is also written, verse 13 says, our husband is known in the gates when he's seated among the elders of the land. You know, when you have somebody who be boastful, that's when you see men walking in my place, like, because they know they have somebody at home. Please let us be a virtuous woman. In everything that you do, let us be a virtuous woman. And that brings me to our role in the church. Turn with me to Titus chapter 2. Titus chapter 2. That's what all I want for you today. That it's not enough for us to have that faith. We need to demonstrate it in everything that we do. that our Father in heaven may be glorified. I read from 3 to 5. The aged men likewise, that they be in a behavior as becometh holiness, not false accusers, not given to much wine, teachers of good things, that they may teach the young women. The young women to be sober, to love their husbands, to love their children, to be discreet, chaste, keepers at home, good, obedient to their own husbands, that the word of God do not blaspheme it. All the children in the church, they belong to you, not only your children. You have been privileged to see them, to watch over them, to show them the way. Our girls, are they married materials? What do you imbibe in them? Do you teach them women lib, women liberation? There's nothing like that in the word of God. There's nothing like that. Let us bring our children up properly. Don't let us nurture them in the standard of the world. Let us teach them within the confines of what God has given unto us. And God, as you are faithful, as you are diligent to do this, surely the Lord God Almighty will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And finally, I want to charge you. In the society, everybody's crying, society, I mean, what we are seeing, we don't like it. It is the final product from every home that you see in the society. The society is the reflection of the family. So let us do our bit so that the society can be better. God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And finally, brethren, I charge you, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on all that you have had to do. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, the glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and nevermore.
Amen.
Shall we rise? I want you to pray, and our husband to pray for us, that God Almighty, that responsibility God has given unto us, that God Almighty be able to fulfill it to God's satisfaction in Jesus' name. Women, ask for the grace where you are weak, that God Almighty will help me, O Lord my God. I know I will account for every soul you have made me to see, even for my husband, I will account.